Good morning, children. This is lecture 3 of chapter Equilibrium. Equilibrium constant expression for some reactions. Following conventions are used while writing equilibrium constant expressions for different chemical equilibria. The first rule is the active mass or the concentration of a solid is unity. Any solid, if it is taking part in a reaction, then its concentration will be taken as unity. The concentration of solid is regarded as constant no matter how much of it is present. So, the active mass of the solid is regarded as unity. The concentration is constant, so active mass is regarded as unity. See, this is one example. CaCO3 solid, it is giving you CaO and CO2. It's a reversible reaction. CaO is solid, CaCO3 is also solid, but CO2 is gas. So, what will be its equilibrium constant? The concentration of the product, that is CaO solid, and the concentration of CO2 gas divided by concentration of the reactant, that is CaCO3 in this case, which is also a solid. Now, CaO is a solid and CaCO3 is a solid, so their concentration has taken as unity, their active mass is unity. So, its equilibrium constant K is only CO2 gas and its concentration, active mass. Okay, number two we will do in the next slide. Number two, the active mass of a liquid in equilibrium with a gas is also unity. That means what? When a liquid is present in equilibrium with a gas, then the concentration of that liquid is regarded constant and its active mass is taken as unity. For example, suppose H2O liquid is changing to H2O gas. It is a reversible reaction. That means it is in equilibrium. Then in that case, K is equals to concentration of the product divided by concentration of the reactant. And you see that the reactant is in the liquid state. So, its active mass is taken as unity. So, its equilibrium constant K we are getting as H2O gas, its active mass. Is it okay, children? Number three. For equilibria in aqueous medium, if the medium is the aqueous one, for equilibria, the active mass of H2O is unity. Okay, the solvent is supposed to be large excess. The solvent is H2O, it's water, because the medium is aqueous medium. So, it is considered to be in large excess, and it is believed that its concentration remain almost unchanged in the reaction. Therefore, if H2O is involved as solvent in the equilibrium constant expression, its active mass is also taken to be unity. For example, suppose the reaction is CH3COO- plus H2O liquid, that is a reversible reaction. It is giving you CH3COO aqueous and OH minus aqueous. Now the K, you all know that it's the concentration of the products divided by concentration of the reactant. So we are getting this expression. Okay, so here you can see that this H2O is in the liquid state. We will take it as unity. So, what we are getting? CH3COO aqueous and OH minus aqueous. divided by CH3COO minus aqueous, all the concentration we are taking, that is your equilibrium constant. Now, equilibrium constant expression for some reaction in this category only, we will see here how to calculate the equilibrium constant for the reaction N2O4 gas is giving you 2NO2 gas. Okay, equilibrium constant K is equals to NO2 gas to the power 2. Why it is to the power 2? Because the stoichiometry of this product is 2 divided by N2O4. This is the equilibrium constant, and this Kp will be P, partial pressure of NO2 to the power 2, divided by partial pressure of N2O4, because both are in the gaseous state. Clear? Next one is C2O4 2 minus aqueous plus PB2 plus aqueous is giving you PbCrO4, that is solid. So its K should be written as PbCrO4 solid product divided by the reactants, concentration of the reactant. Okay, now in this you can see that the product reactant PbCrO4, it is in the solid state. So its concentration will be taken as 1. So what we are getting? 1 divided by CrO4 aqueous and Pb2 plus aqueous. I hope it is clear to you. See here another reaction, Cu solid plus 2Ag plus aqueous is giving you Cu2 plus aqueous plus 2Ag solid. So the equilibrium constant K is equal to Cu2 plus aqueous and the concentration of Ag solid to the power 2, because 2 is the stoichiometry, you have to take care of the stoichiometry also, divided by Cu solid here and Ag plus to the power 2, because its stoichiometry is also 2. Now here you can see that this Ag is in the solid state and this Cu is also in the solid state. So their concentration will be taken as unity. Their active mass will be taken as unity. So what we are getting, the K for this particular reaction will be Cu2 plus aqueous divided by Ag plus aqueous to the power 2. Is it okay, children? The next one is AgCl solid is giving you Ag plus aqueous plus Cl minus aqueous. So this is you are getting for K. Now here you can see that AgCl is the solid, is in solid state. So it will be taken as unity 1. So what we are getting, K is equals to Ag plus aqueous and Cl minus aqueous. The third one, N2 gas plus O2 gas is giving you 2NO gas. This is, all these are in the gaseous state. So K for this reaction is NO to the power 2, stoichiometry is 2, divided by N2 gas and O2 gas. Okay, and the Kp for this reaction, as they are in the gaseous state, PNO to the power 2 divided by PN2 into PO2. I hope it is clear to you. One more reaction, NH3 aqueous plus H2O liquid. You can see here H2O is in liquid. So naturally its concentration will be 1. It's giving you NH4 plus aqueous and OH minus aqueous. So K will be NH4 plus aqueous and OH minus aqueous divided by NH3 aqueous and H2O liquid. And H2O liquid is 1. So its K is given by this expression. CH3COO aqueous plus H2O liquid. Here also H2O liquid. It's giving you CH3COO aqueous plus H3O plus aqueous. So its K will be given by this expression, because H2O, here H2O liquid is also coming, and this is giving This is H2O liquid is 1. So the expression, in the expression H2O will not be there. Is it okay? Units of equilibrium constant. In the expression for Kc, what is Kc? Kc is equals to equilibrium constant for concentration terms. When we are taking concentration terms. Now the previous example where we have written K, it actually stands for Kc. So instead of K, you can always write Kc. Because we have taken the concentration term, that is the active mass. The active masses are expressed in moles per liter because they are the concentration term. So concentration is taken as mole per liter. So the active masses are expressed in moles per liter. While that for Kp, the active masses are expressed in atmosphere. So the unit of equilibrium constant depends upon the number of moles of the reactant and the products. That means the stoichiometric coefficient. How many number of moles of the reactants have taken part and how many number of moles of the products we are getting. So the Kp and Kc are different for different reaction. See, the reaction is H2 gas plus I2 gas is giving you 2HI gas. So the Kc is H2 to the power 2 divided by H2 and I2. So the concentration for HI to the power 2 will be mole per liter to the power 2 divided by mole per liter for H2 and mole per liter for I2. Okay, so what we are getting, if I'll do this, I am getting mole square liter minus 2 divided by, multiply this 2, this is also mole square and liter minus 2. So I am getting 1. That means no unit. It is having no unit. It will get cancelled. It's having no unit. Okay. And what is Kp for this reaction? Because this all are in the gaseous state. So it is PHI to the power 2 divided by PH2 and PI2. So this is atmosphere square divided by atmosphere into atmosphere. So here also we are getting no unit. And that is why it is said, when the sum of the stoichiometric coefficient of the reactant and that for the product are equal, then in that case, both Kc and Kp are dimensionless. They have no unit. Am I clear? Now see, for this reaction, N2 gas plus 3H2 gas is giving you 2NH3 gas. Now, how to write the Kc for this reaction? Kc for this reaction is NH3 to the power 2 divided by N2 and H2 to the power 3 because its stoichiometry is 3. Now, NH3 to the power 2 can be written as mole liter minus 1 to the power 2. And for N2, it is mole liter minus 1. And for H2 to the power 3 is mole liter minus 1 to the power 3. Now calculate this one. Let me calculate here. What we are getting, this one, I am getting mole square liter minus 2 divided by, this is mole liter minus 1, and for this one it is mole cube liter minus 3. Okay, now what we are getting here, mole square liter minus 2 divided by, this is mole and mole cube, so it is mole to the power 4, and this is liter minus 1 and this is liter minus 3, so it is liter minus 4. Okay, liter minus 4. Now, this will be mole square liter minus 2. This will go as mole minus 4 and liter plus 4. So, what we are getting, mole minus 2 and liter square. See, here also it is mole minus 2 liter square. Okay. For Kp, it is atmosphere to the power minus 2. Because this will come, NH3 will be atmosphere to the power 2. Now for N2 it is atmosphere and for H2 it is atmosphere cube. So in the denominator we are getting atmosphere to the power 4. When that will go to the numerator, it will be as minus 4. So this is plus 2 and minus 4. It will come as atmosphere minus 2. And that is why it is said that when the sum of the stoichiometric coefficient of the reactant and that for the products are unequal, in that case, what we are doing, we are calculating in this way, that is delta N. If delta N is the difference in the sum of the stoichiometric coefficient of the gaseous product and the gaseous reactant, then unit of Kc is mole liter minus 1 to the power delta N. And unit for Kp, atmosphere to the power delta N. Okay. So, for this particular reaction, it is given here. This delta N is equals to 2 minus 3 plus 1. Okay. This is 2. This is 2. This stoichiometric 2 minus 3 is here and 1 is here. So, 3 plus 1. So, I'm getting minus 2. But you need not to go with this. You can straight away do like that. You can straight away start from this. Okay. So, what is given here? Thus, it may be summarized that K is dimensionless when the total number of moles of the reactant is equal to the total number of moles of the product. In other cases, it has specific unit as the case may be. So, just write down the units and calculate. Am I clear? That will be easy for you. Application of laws of mass action and law of chemical equilibrium. Law of mass action and law of chemical equilibrium are very useful in predicting the course of a reaction when some of the reaction parameters such as concentration, pressure are changed. This also helps to predict how a chemical reaction should change when an inert gas is added to the system. This will be explained with the help of certain chemical reactions. Okay, in the next following slides, this will be explained to you. Dissociation of nitrogen tetroxide. When nitrogen tetroxide, that is N2O4, is heated in a closed vessel, it dissociates into nitrogen dioxide and the following equilibrium is established between the two. See, N2O4 is, when dissociate, it is giving you 2NO2. Let A, this is A, be the number of moles of N2O4 taken initially in a closed vessel of volume V liters. A be the number of moles of N2O4 is taken in a vessel, closed vessel of course, which is having a volume V liters. See, this is V liters. And let X moles of it from A, we have taken initially at A, the number of moles A, from that A, X moles of it dissociate till equilibrium is attained. I think it is clear to you. First, we have taken A moles of N2O4 in a vessel which is having a volume V, and after certain time when the reaction is attaining the equilibrium, that time maybe X moles of it is dissociated. Okay. On dissociation, it is giving 2 moles of NO2. 2 moles of NO2. We can see from this reaction. Okay. So, X mole of N2O4 will dissociate to give 2X mole of NO2. X mole of N2O4 is dissociating to give you 2X mole of NO2. So, we can write it in this way. N2O4 is giving you 2 NO2. This is a reaction. Now, initial number of moles was A and 0. And after certain times when it is attaining the equilibrium, the number of moles at equilibrium for N2O4, it will remain as A minus X because X mole dissociated. But here we are getting 2X moles of NO2. Is it okay? So, at equilibrium, NO2, the concentration of NO2 is number of moles per volume. So, it will be A minus X by V because in the V vessel we have taken the reactant. The reaction is going on a vessel which is having a volume V. So, its concentration is A minus X by V. And the concentration of the product, that is NO2, is equals to 2X by V. Is it okay? So, applying the law of mass action and law of equilibrium, what we are getting as equilibrium constant Kc? NO2 to the power 2, because my reaction is N2O4 is giving you 2NO2. So, it is Kc will be NO2 to the power 2 because its stoichiometry is 2. And N2O4 is the concentration of N2O4 is the reactant. NO2 we have got 2X by V and to the power 2. And N2O4 we have got A minus X by V. If we'll calculate, we are getting 4X square by A minus X into V. Clear? Because this one we will get 4x square by v square. This will be into v divided by a minus x. Now v and square is getting cancelled. So we are getting 4x square divided by a minus x into v, this equation. Okay. Now, in this reaction, the effect of changing various factor will be discussed in the next slide. This is the Kc that we have got for this reaction. Now, if I change the pressure, then what will happen? If I change the volume, then what? Now, see here, effect of changing pressure, how it is affecting the Kc for that particular reaction. What was my reaction? Let me first write it. N2O4 is giving you 2NO2. And what is the Kc for this reaction we have got? Kc is equals to 4x square divided by A minus X into V. This expression we have got Kc for this reaction. Now, suppose I'm changing the pressure. The right-hand side of this reaction is having V in the denominator. Now, If I'll change pressure, naturally volume will change. If I'm increasing pressure, so volume will decrease. If I'm decreasing pressure, volume will increase. So that means if I change the pressure, there is a direct effect in the volume. So let us first take the case when the pressure is increased. When the pressure is increased. If the pressure is increased, volume will decrease. As the volume is in denominator, okay, so if the volume is decreasing, naturally the Kc will increase. Okay, suppose my expression I'm getting now 5 by 4. We are getting 1.2 something. Okay, but if the denominator is decreasing, suppose it is 5 by 2, I'm getting 2.5. So what I'm saying, if I'm decreasing the value of V, which is in the denominator, by increasing the pressure, then what will happen? The value of Kc will increase in that case. But this is not possible because value of K is constant. It's a constant term, equilibrium constant. Kc is nothing but equilibrium constant. Okay, so it will remain constant as long as the temperature is constant. Here I'm changing only the pressure. I'm not changing the temperature. I'm changing the pressure. I'm increasing the pressure. The value of V is decreasing. If I'm increasing the pressure, the volume decreases. The value of volume decreases means this is try to increase the value of Kc. Clear? But Kc will not change. Under these circumstances, Kc can remain constant. How? Only when the value of x decreases. This is also, there is also x. The value of x, here is also x. The value of x decreases. What is the meaning of x decrease of x? That means the less dissociation, because x we have taken number of moles dissociated. Okay, so what it is showing, increase in the pressure leads to decrease in the dissociation of N2O4. And just the reverse, if you decrease the pressure, then it will lead to greater dissociation of N2O4. Hence, it may be very important, it may be concluded that the dissociation of N2O4 increases with a decrease in pressure. So for this type of reaction, pressure increase of pressure is not favorable for this type of reaction. This reaction, the dissociation will be more, that means my yield will be more if we will reduce the pressure. Am I clear? Number two, effect of changing concentration of N2O4. If you change the concentration of N2O4, then what will happen? If the concentration of N2O4 is increased, suppose I'm increased the concentration of N2O4. Whatever we have taken initially, we are taking more than that. Then what will happen? The value of A increases because we have taken more, the concentration is more, so the value of A will increase. So, what was my equation? This is the equation. Kc is equals to NO2 to the power 2 divided by N2O4. So, under these circumstances, the value of K can remain constant only when the value of X increases. Clear? That is, more N2O4 dissociate into NO2. More concentration, more will be expressed. More will be dissociation. Okay, so an increase in the concentration of N2O4 will favor its dissociation. You can understand it. If more concentration you will take, more dissociation will take place. Number of moles, if you will take more, then the dissociation also will be more. That means my product also will be more. On the other hand, if the concentration of NO2 increased, if this is increased, the value of K in this expression Kc can remain constant only when the concentration of N2O4 increases. If the product is more, you have to increase the, when the product will be more, when the reactant, number of moles of the reactant is more. This is possible only when some NO2 gets converted into N2O4. Hence, an increase in concentration of NO2 will suppress the dissociation of N2O4. If you increase the concentration of NO2, suppose, by some way, you are adding some NO2 from outside, then what will happen? Then it will go back. It will be a reverse reaction. Okay, it will not try to take, it will not try to get more NO2. It will not try to form more NO2. So it will be, the dissociation of N2O4 will be suppressed. Clear? Dissociation of hydrogen iodide, another example. On being heated in a closed vessel, hydrogen iodide dissociates into hydrogen and iodine. HI will dissociate into H2 and I2. And an equilibrium is established between them. Suppose initially A moles of HI are taken in a closed vessel of volume V liters. And suppose X mole of it is dissociate till equilibrium is attained. Now, since 2 moles of HI on dissociation give 1 mole of H2 and 1 mole of I2, so if I am taking X mole of it, that is HI, is dissociate to give X by 2 moles of H2 and X by 2 moles of I2. Suppose I have taken 2HI is giving you H2 and I2. That means what? 2 moles of HI is giving you 1 mole of H and 1 mole of I. Okay. Now, if I am taking A or X, whatever it may be, X mole, suppose X mole dissociate to give, from 2 I am getting 1 and 1, that means it's half, so X dissociate will give X by 2 and X by 2. It's okay. Now, initial number of moles, suppose I have taken A for HI, and the initially there will be no product, so it is 0 and 0. Number of moles at equilibrium, X mole dissociated, so it will be A minus X. And it will be X by 2 and X by 2. Is it okay? So, at equilibrium, what we are getting? HI is A minus X by V. Because what was there? 2HI is giving you H2 and I2. So, initial concentration A00, it's not concentration, A number of A moles were taken. Okay. Now, after dissociation, suppose X mole dissociated, so it will be as A minus X and it will be X by 2 and X by 2. I hope you have understood. What is the concentration then? We have taken in a vessel which is having volume V. So, for concentration HI will be A minus X by V, and for concentration H2, it will be X by 2V, and I2 is also equals to x by 2v. See, it is written here. Hi is equals to a minus x by v. H2 is equals to x by 2v and I2 is equals to x by 2v. So now apply law of mass action. So Kc is equals to concentration of the product H2 I2 divided by the reactant, that is Hi to the power 2, because the stoichiometry is 2. This is a reaction. Stoichiometry is 2. Now write down the concentration x by 2v into x by 2v divided by a minus x to the power 2. Calculate it. You will get x square divided by 4a minus x whole square. I am just showing it here. X square by 4v square into reverse, that is v square a minus x whole square. V square gets cancelled. So we are getting x square divided by 4a minus x whole square. With the help of the reaction, the effect of changing various factors on dissociation of Hi can be discussed. Let me first write down whatever the Kc we have got for this reaction. Kc is equals to x square divided by 4a minus x whole square. This is the expression that I got, the equilibrium constant for the dissociation of Hi. Okay, now effect of changing pressure, the first one. You are changing the pressure. But you can see that here in this expression, there is no volume term. Okay, so you can understand that Kc here for this particular reaction is independent of the volume. So there will be no effect on changing the pressure on dissociation of Hi. Am I clear? In the other words, we can say that the dissociation of Hi is not affected by any change in pressure. Am I clear? If you change the pressure, then volume will increase or decrease. It is affecting directly on the volume. But this expression is not having any volume term. So this expression is Kc for this reaction is independent of volume. So there is no effect if we change the pressure. Now here, effect of changing concentration. What is the Kc for that particular reaction we have got? Kc is equals to x square divided by 4a minus x. Now you are changing the concentration of Hi. If you are changing the concentration of Hi, that means you are changing the value of A. Now you can see the reaction, this one, this equation. Under these circumstances, if you are changing the value of A, if you are changing the value of A, that means the denominator is changing. So under these circumstances, the Kc will remain constant, because Kc is a constant term. It's equilibrium constant, so it's constant term. It is remaining constant. How it is possible? Only when the value of x increases. You are increasing the value of A, that means the value of x is also increasing. That means more Hi will get dissociate, because you have to get the value of x more. Dissociation will be more. Hence, an increase in the concentration, increase in the concentration of Hi will favor its dissociation. You all know about it. If you increase the concentration of the product, the reactant will also increase. Okay. On the other hand, if the concentration of H2 and I2 is increased, concentration of Hi must increase. Otherwise, this will not remain constant. More hydrogen and iodine must combine to form more Hi. Hence, an increase in the concentration of H2 or I2 suppresses the dissociation of Hi. Am I clear to you? Effect of adding an inert gas. An inert gas can be added either at constant volume or at constant pressure. Both the cases you can add inert gas. So first case I am taking. At constant volume, my equation is 2HI is giving you H2 and I2. What is my Kc I have got for this reaction? Kc is equal to x square divided by 4a minus x. Now, at constant volume, we are not changing the volume, but you are adding an inert gas. That means you are not changing the volume, you are adding an inert gas. So, that means you are not changing the number of moles of individual species. The number of moles of individual species remain unchanged. Thus, the value of x does not change. You are not changing the number of moles. So, value dissociation, number of moles dissociate is also is not changing. Hence, there is no effect on adding an inert gas at constant volume to the dissociation of HI. Number two, at constant pressure. Now, you are keeping the pressure constant, but you are adding the inert gas. In that case, the total volume of the system increases. But see this expression, Kc is independent of the volume. So, there is no effect of adding an inert gas at constant pressure. I hope you have understood. Now, synthesis of ammonia by Haber's process. In the Haber's process, ammonia is synthesized by the combination of nitrogen and hydrogen. You all know about it. When nitrogen and hydrogen are mixed, they combine together under suitable sets of conditions. You all know that high pressure, high temperature, that catalyst, promoter, everything required. In that case, N2 gas and H2 gas will react to give you NH3 gas. Okay, and an equilibrium is established. Suppose initially A moles of nitrogen and B moles of hydrogen, because here are two different gases. So A moles of nitrogen and B moles of hydrogen are taken in a closed vessel, but you are taking in a same vessel, you are just adding the two gases. So the volume is V liter for that vessel. And suppose X mole of nitrogen react till equilibrium is reached. According to the above equation, 1 mole of nitrogen from here, 1 mole of nitrogen react with 3 moles of hydrogen to give 2 moles of NH3. Hence, X mole of nitrogen combine 3 moles of H2 to give 2 moles of NH3. Am I clear? Here from this reaction, it is clear that N2 plus 3H2 is giving you 2NH3. It's giving you 2NH3. So, 1 mole of N2 and 3 moles of H2 is giving you 2 moles of NH3. So, if I am taking X mole of N2 is reacting with 3X mole of H2 and it is giving 2X mole of NH3. Okay. Now, next. See here, initial number of moles. We have taken A moles of N2 is reacting with B moles of H2 is giving you 0, because initial state it will be 0 number of moles of the product. Now at equilibrium, number of moles, I said that X moles of N2 is reacting with 3X moles of H2 is giving you 2X moles of NH3. So number of moles which is remaining at equilibrium will be A minus X. It will be B minus 3x and it will be 2x. Now write down the concentration at equilibrium. The concentration of N2 at equilibrium will be A minus x by V, because the volume of that container is V. H2 will be B minus 3x by V, and concentration of NH3 is equals to 2x by V. See here, this one and this one. Now applying the law of mass action, Kc is equals to NH3 to the power 2 by N2 and H2 to the power 3. With the stoichiometry you have to write that, and just put the concentration here, and after calculation you will get this one. Do this calculation and see that whether you are getting this or not. Okay, now with this reaction, with this equation, let us see what are the effect of changing various factor for this reaction. Effect of changing pressure. Okay, if the pressure is increased, before saying anything, let me first write down the Kc for this reaction. Kc for this reaction is equals to 4x square V square divided by A minus x and B minus 3x whole to the power 3. Now, effect of changing pressure. If the pressure is increased, the volume V will decrease. Okay. Hence, in order to maintain the value of K constant, V is in the numerator here. The value of X must increase. This must increase. Okay. This will also increase. But as V is increasing, this denominator value will also should be increased. Otherwise, we cannot maintain the constant value for Kc. Thus, more nitrogen will combine. The value of X must increase. No? So, X is the number of moles of N2 combined with H2. So, the more number of nitrogen will combine with more number of hydrogen to form more ammonia. And that is why in Hever's process, an increase in pressure will favor the formation of ammonia. And that is why for this particular reaction, high pressure is required. If you will give high pressure, apply high pressure, then in that case, volume will decrease. And naturally, to maintain Kc, X must be increased. Okay, X must be increased. So that means more ammonia will form. It will increase more pressure. Now, number B, effect of increase the concentration of N2 and H2. An increase in the concentration of N2 or H2, an increase in the value of A or B increases. The denominator, this value A and B will increase in denominator. Okay, under these circumstances, how to maintain the constant value for K? If you can increase the value of X also. So, an increase in the concentration of N2 and H2 will favor the formation of ammonia. If we'll increase more, the value of reactant, number of moles of reactant will be more, then your product will also be more. I hope it is clear to you now. But children, please go through all these things, because these all are important. Am I clear? So along with this, I'm ending lecture 3 here. And in the next lecture, we will start after this.